Each morning, one of the microlights makes a short flight to a neighbouring meadow with the older birds following closely behind. As these birds are all 1 year old, they are already familiar with this routine. As the Waldrapp forage amongst the short grass, Peter Pilz records valuable information about their feeding habits and the social interactions between the birds. Much of this data will be useful in the management of habitats where bald ibis may be the focus of further reintroduction programmes, and also in selecting suitable stopover sites along the proposed migration route. Protestations from a local dog do not appear to bother the ibis. They just carry on with their foraging. Sometimes, however, it is easier to scrounge food from one's foster parents. Continuing to hand feed the birds is important at this stage in order to maintain the bond between bird and foster parent. After just a few hours at the meadow, Angelica, Peter and the birds return to the airfield in Schoenstein. As Isabel and Angelica coax the birds into their transport boxes and cages, Johannes and Peter load them carefully into the backs of two estates cars. Today the birds are having a special treat. They are being taken on a short trip up into the mountains. In these mountains, close to the airfield, there is an old ruin, and the team have erected artificial roosting ledges here. Historical records tell of Waldrapp nesting in rock faces and the ruins of old castles and towers not too dissimilar to these. Once the birds have been transported to the site, they are released from their boxes and food and water is provided by the foster parents. There are ruins such as these throughout the Alps, and Johannes and the team have brought the birds here in order to familiarise them to such places. It is hoped that the birds may utilise old ruins as roosting and possibly breeding sites in the future. The birds begin to forage for food almost as soon as they are released from their cages, and whilst Angelica, Alex and Peter look after the birds, Johannes has slipped quietly away. Panting helps the birds to keep cool, and on a hot summer's day like today, there's nothing better than a spot of sunbathing. In due course, the sound of a distant engine heralds the return of Dr. Fritz with Isabel. As Isabel calls from the back of the microlight, the birds take to the air to follow them back to the airfield. The following day, a westerly wind came to Schoenstein, heralding the arrival of inclement weather. The alpine weather can be very fickle in the summer, and the microlights can often be grounded for several days. Even weather conditions that are suitable for fixed-winged aircraft can be wholly unsuitable for microlights, and thunderstorms can materialise quite literally out of the blue. The Waldrapp do not need to weather this thunderstorm for very long, and almost as quickly as it arrived, the storm has passed. As the sun breaks through the clouds, great plumes of steam begin to evaporate from the rain-drenched hillsides, and birdsong returns once more to the valley.